So, yeah, anyway, I'll try to look a little bit more. What is this, the terminology? I don't know. Less of an eyesore. And so that's curious, a curious interest, yeah. So I don't know, I was when in this discussion of city planning, and yeah, and this is my upgrade, that's extra funny. Okay, in the city planning, I like to look at it actually, you know, try to look at it from the bird's eye view, looking down upon the properties, okay. So, I know I went on with that Teletubby idea, and it is a little bit coffin-y, so I'm not really sure about it completely, but it has to, yeah, I am a little bit, but yes, you know, yeah, you can't be too in tomb, much like a tomb, you know, so anyway, I just finished this one. It's like a little funny painting of the pony dog, but then I went in with the metallics. Okay, now the little pony dog here is the perfect if you're the bird and you're looking down upon the bird, okay, down on the land as a bird, okay, so like here you have like this if you can imagine that, like this flower, each petal of the flower is a residential area, so that's like one residential area with houses. And then there's the next residential, and then there's the next, okay, so all the way around. And so here in the middle is a city center, but it's a city center that is not built up like the spike domes. It's a city center that is just like this little tiny microcosm space that has a park on top of it. That's really all I'm trying to get at, you know, so it's actually an area that you can still use, you know what I mean? Like your eye can just keep going from one side of the residential area pretty much over to the other, you know, so it's not such a disruption. All right, yeah, and so this is kind of a funny one, because in a way, if you put it down as like a map, you know, that's really it, you know, that's all city planning is. And gosh dang it, we really just, when did this all start? We started doing this like in the 1900s with the bricks, and then it just went on and on and on and on. You see, after the wood, we had the wood pile, log cabin building, and then we went straight to the bricks. And then everything after that was just like a disaster. Just a disaster. Because something happened, and it was the Metal Age. It became the Metal Age again, and what was beams and metals everywhere. You know, just, that's it. We learned how to make skyscrapers. You know, after the pyramid. Not the pyramid, come on. The Empire State. After that Empire State was built, it was just like, forget it. Every town, every city had to have that type of bricks and metal construction. So here we are with this. And then I'm wondering, well, who wants to live, you know, over here, where is it, this little fish zone, or this one, who wants to live there, you know, in those little tiny, like, bubble zones, you know, there could be something going on, you know, and so I don't know, how is this construction of the future going to be? How are we going to look at this construction of the future? You know, it has to get a little better than this Roman street, you know, right, left, straight, forward, that's it, you know. It's just so uncreative. The Romans just were not creative, you know. And don't say, well, I won't be able to find myself around. You could. You could say, I live in the dove zone. I live where the dove is, you know, so here's the dove. You know, I live where the dove is, you know. That's it. You know, where do you live? Oh my gosh, you know, green flower number two or whatever, you know. So that's the way it goes, or give it a name, you know, like Gavella. You know, so it gets a name. I live in Gavella green flower, you know. And so here this is what's going on. And so then there's the pony dog. Oh my God, you live with the pony dog? No. That is so wrong. That's like only for like really young people. Only really young people. Lively actions going on at the pony dog. You know, lots of restaurants and activity. You know. So it's that's the fun. You know, that's the fun of it. I don't know. Art is really hard. Art is so difficult. I am not having fun, you know, and I'm like, I'm going to be an art teacher. I already am an art teacher. And then I'm like, well, in an odd, weird, strange way, gosh, it sure does beat you up. It sure does beat you up. You put the line, the pen to the paper, whatever you're doing, it can beat you up, you know, the shape and form, you know. And I'll say, yeah, congratulations, Mr. and Mrs. Modern Art, Mr. and Mrs. Contemporary, throwing your splats around. You sure do get it easy. You get it easy, and you know it. As soon as you get into shape and form, this is a hard, hard bastard. And you know it. It's difficult. Art is one difficult katuna. Just difficult. So yeah, I don't know. As much as modern art, much as I love it, as much as I love contemporary art, it's the beast. The beast is always going to be shape and form. Can you pull it off? Can you pull off shape and form? Anyway, so back to the pony dog. Obviously a Disney character. Doesn't have to be Disney, but yeah, he's a little dog that's also a pony that little boys and girls can carry around from ages, oh my goodness, probably 3 to 8 years old. And 36-year-old women can still keep them little pony dogs on their shelves, memoirs of their childhood that they cannot release. He can be a little movie. What else can he be? Oh my gosh, I also said a squirt toy, like in the tub. I like him as a squirt toy. And he has to be royal blue. Yeah. So here's the little Yumba Yumba, the pony dog. So how do we make lots of money off of him, folks? I want stuffed toys, stuffed animals, pony dog. Little kids holding on to their pony dog. Little pony dog, what do you call it? Backpacks. The opposite of Hello Kitty. Right, so yeah, marketer. All right, good night.